G'day guys, back again. How good is this channel getting? I mean, seriously, 500 videos? The quality of the kids that are coming out on this channel, I mean, seriously. I don't want you to answer this, and don't tell me if I'm wrong, but this has got to be one of the best YouTube channels when it comes to diversity and model kits that aren't Gundam and that aren't 144 scale Bandai Star Wars kits. I mean, guys, I mean, this is unprecedented. It's unprecedented in this time and period. And obviously, this kit is just proving the fact. There we have it. 1991. What a lovely year that was. Look at this. 1/12 scale. Class 2 power loader with Ripley. My goodness. What a lovely movie that was. Gave me nightmares, actually, guys. I don't like to talk about it too much because I was pretty young at the time and I had a lot of nightmares. There was a lot of bedwetting after this movie. Sometimes just because I was dreaming about horrible things in this movie. Other times it was because I didn't want to get out of my bed to go to the toilet because I was scared that this little fella might be sitting in there waiting for me. So I was pretty scared about going to the toilet. So a lot of changing the sheets went on for a couple of months after I'd seen this movie, guys. But I'm sure you're all the same. I'm sure everyone had the same story. I'm not unusual in that. I'm sure it was pretty much everyone had the same problem. I mean, I was 25 at the time, but I'm pretty sure all 25-year-olds were doing the same thing at that time. Absolutely love this kit. Now, guys, if you haven't been onto my channel for long, and as I say, what a crack of a channel. I've done a little bit of a show and tell. I like to call it show and tell. It reminds me back of my grade 3 days. Of a 132 scale kit I've picked up of this. 132. This one's 172. I'm talking 132. Massive. This one here, I think, off the top of my head. Now, guys, I'm not a genius. I'm just going off my memory. So forgive me if I'm wrong. I think this one's 135. Now, I have done a video not so long ago of a kit I've picked up of this, which is, I think, I can't remember, 123rd scale, 123rd scale. And I've also got another little kit of from Prodos Games. It's around 128mm, you know, the sort of Warhammer-y game sort of scale type thing. So we'll have a look at that one a bit later on. It's quite a nice kit, actually. Quite a nice kit. Quite surprised by it, actually. A little bit of information there. Look at the box art on this. I mean, this is absolutely beautiful drawing or painting. I can never work out, guys. Is it a drawing or painting? I don't know. If I had this power loader parked beside my bed all those many years ago, I probably would have gone to the toilet because I could have just snapped that alien's head in half. But no, I didn't, guys. I didn't. I was only in my boxer shorts. Speaking of ugly, this figure, guys, you know I like my figures. I don't really have any qualms with the body. Straps coming over the shoulders. It's just the head, guys. The head is, what would you say, horrendous. Horrendous is the word I'll use tonight. Looks a little bit of a cross between, off the top of my head, let's go the Donald and Wolverine. Imagine maybe Donald Trump with Wolverine's hairstyle. That's what you're getting, guys. So it's really another set of nightmares, really, for me after doing this video, because I haven't seen this face for quite some time. The hands, look, guys, I think this was done in the early 1990s, but, you know, the hands are not, they're not too bad. They're not too bad. They're pretty much up to, you know, old Tamiya standard for bigger figures. Holy dooly, look at the size of this instruction sheet. Could it get any bigger? Oh, thank God, it's only one page. I mean, I thought it was going to be like, you know, a dragon model kit where I'd probably have to go and see a shrink before I started. Especially was the, you know, optional 23-in-1 kit. But anyway, pretty simple kit to go together, guys. Main thing you're going to be doing here, apart from playing with some tubing, is doing a fair bit of putting with all the seams here, joining it together. It's a pretty much a weekend build, not so much for the painting. I'd say, you know, the painting might be another weekend or two. That's me. I'm slow, guys, in lots of areas. And see what, they haven't skimped on the size of this drawing, have they? Pretty basic there, guys. It's yellow and it's silver. Let's have a look at this. This is the, what would you call them? The claws? The claw. The claws, the hands, the clamps, whatever you want to call them. Pretty simple. As I said, made in the early 90s, I think, this kit. So it's pretty basic. But then again, you know, I think the machinery or the power loader would be pretty basic. It doesn't need a lot of detail on it. Only just needs to function the way it should function. Let's have a look at this little leg here. 13 centimeters long. just on the leg there. So that's a pretty decent size. You can see there, I did, I think, maybe I haven't glued this together. Oh, I thought I'd glued this together, but I haven't, guys. There you go. That's pretty handy, isn't it? Oh yeah, that's pretty good for gluing then. I thought that was glued. I thought I did a bad job, but there you go. Again, some nice detailing on this, some nice washes. I mean, you know, you could obviously super detail this and add little other trinkets and little things on it. My only thing with this kit is I'm just undecided. I know I'm going to alienate people, but I don't know if I want to paint this yellow, guys. And I know that's such a terrible thing to say, but I don't know. I kind of like thinking of a bit of an olive drab color. I'm just not a big fan of yellow, and I know it's, and I loved it in the movie, don't get me wrong, but I'm just not a big fan of yellow. So they're nice, some little serial numbers there. I hadn't noticed that before. So I don't know, guys. I don't know if I'm going to paint it yellow or not. Haven't really got to that stage yet, as you can tell, but it's 50-50 on the yellow. Here we go with the arms. Again, really nice with the sort of serial numbers on there. And geez, I've forgotten how big this kit is. It's actually going to be quite a big kit when it goes together. And I don't know, as I've said with the figure, I'm not a huge fan of the figure. I may search to see if I can get a decent Sigourney Weaver head in 1/12 scale, or just a decent 1/12 scale head altogether. And if I can't, I may just leave the figure out of it. There's a really nice one of these done up on YouTube, which I'll leave a link to down below if you're still watching. And I think the guy's done a really good job on it. I think he's only got, at the moment, so forgive me, at the moment while I'm doing this video, he's got 7 subscribers. So I'd love it if you went and checked out his video. And if you actually like what he's done, which I do, I think it's fantastic. I'd love it if you liked his video and maybe even subscribe to his channel, because he's got 7 subscribers. And I think he's doing a good job. I think he's got about 4 or 5 videos up. And I don't know this guy from a bar of soap. I don't even know what country he's in or whatever. But I just looked up, I think he's done 4 or 5 videos, and I thought, yeah, they're nice models, dude. They're nice models. So do me a favor, if you don't mind my channel, have a look at his channel. 7 subscribers, and I'd love to see, just out of kindness, if you like his video on the power loader, and maybe subscribe to his channel, you know, if you choose to. But yeah, I just thought that'd be a nice thing to do. Jeez, I wasn't expecting, after looking at the first couple of trees, I wasn't expecting this. There's quite a bit of stuff on this. There's something about these sort of seats, guys, or, you know, the back of the seats, the padding. It's something better. I just love the look of it. Again, when I look at these big pieces, it just reminds me of like a mech at a Mech Warrior or something like that. I know technically it is kind of like a bit mechy, but yeah, when I see these big pieces, it just reminds me of a Mad Cat or a Vulture or something like that, or a Mad Dog, whatever you want to call them. Quite a few parts on that one. Not much to see on the back here. Here's the other leg here. I just love the solidness of this kit. Nice and thick. Holy, look at this. And you know what I love about this kit? Well, I'm gonna tell you. I love that they've given you the correct orange little flashing light thing up the top there, which you could obviously put a little light in if you wanted to. So many kits, you know, even to me, you know how to me still sometimes don't give you bloody proper headlights, you know, in their kits. They just do them molded in whatever plastic they are, and they don't give you a clear bit. So I really do like, oh goodness me, I've just spotted a little bit of PE in there. Wasn't expecting that either. Look at all this tubing. They've given you the little orange light. I don't know if it's going to come out, guys, but you can see it in there. If I can see it, you guys can see it. You can just see in the back there, they've got the little PE part for the top of the mesh, top of the little cage there. And the decals as well, which, you know, I would be a bit terrified using these because they almost look like they've gone a bit grey, unless they were always that way, but they're looking a little bit grey in colour. But some of these other ones, you know, if I... Good thing about these sort of power loader things, or, you know, sci-fi stuff, you know, if one of your decals breaks, just scratch it, guys. Weather it up, do some scratches over the top of it, make it look like it was always supposed to be that way. That's what I do anyway, because I make a lot of mistakes, guys. A lot of mistakes. God, look at the amount of tubing. That's amazing. That rates the kit a lot higher up for me. I love the kit already, don't get me wrong. The head on the figure, horrendous. But the rest of it, absolutely love it. as I said before, probably the main thing will be doing all your little seam lines, cleaning that up. That's going to be your major pain in the butt of this kit. Anyway, guys, as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you later.